Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about functions and responsibilities of a company's board of directors and its committees. So let's begin. The first part of this topic is structure of the board of directors. Board of director ka structure kya hota hai? So the first point says the BOD consists of many directors having knowledge and experience in areas like finance, strategic planning, risk management, law, etc. So there are various directors from various fields, not just finance, it can be any field. Law bhi hota hai usme, finance bhi hota hai, risk management hai, strategies hai, marketing hai, and so on. As we saw earlier, a one-tier board has one board of directors, including internal, matlab ke executive directors, as well as external directors which are non-executive. If you remember this, one tier matlab only one board of directors, and that board will include both internal as well as external directors, or in other words I can say executive directors and non-executive directors. Executive directors kaun the? Those were the employees of the company. Non-executive directors kaun the? Those were outsiders, independent directors. Then there was a two-tier board. Two-tier board has supervisory board having non-executive directors and a management board which is executive directors. So now in this case, supervisory board will actually supervise the management board, meaning non-executive ones will actually supervise on the executive ones. Non-executive directors are independent, whereas executive directors are usually employees or the managers of the company. One-tier board is chaired by the company's CEO. Now, every board of directors will have a chairman. So here in this case, normally, one-tier BOD jo hota hai, uska chairman would be the company's CEO itself. The management board of two-tier BOD is also chaired by the company's CEO. Not the supervisory board, but the management board of the two-tier BOD structure will also be chaired by the company's CEO. In some nations, the CEO and chairman of BOD are to be different persons. Even in India, SEBI ka bahut sara regulations hai jo bolta hai ki company ka CEO hai, wahi agar board of directors ka chairman rahega, to it won't be fair. So let these two roles be separated. Let the CEO do his job. Let the chairman of the board do his job, and let these two be different. BOD meetings are held several times every year. हर साल में 3 से 4 बार ये मीटिंग होती है. इवन इन इंडिया नॉर्मली 4 times अ ईयर देर आर बीओडी मीटिंग्स. देर इज़ वन लीड इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर ऑन द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स. एज द नेम सजेस्ट, ही और शी विल लीड ऑल द अदर इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स. ही और शी कॉल्स मीटिंग्स ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स. सो नाउ देर आर इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स हु आर नॉट द एम्प्लॉयज ऑफ माई कंपनी, दे आर नॉट रिलेटेड टू माई कंपनी. वो सारे इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स का भी एक बॉस होता है, विच इज़ द लीड इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर, एंड द डायरेक्टर कैन कॉल मीटिंग्स ऑफ द अदर इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स. अ डायरेक्टर कैन बी अपॉइंटेड फॉर मल्टीपल ईयर्स. हाउएवर, स्टैगर्ड बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स हैज इलेक्शंस फॉर सम डायरेक्टर्स एवरी ईयर. अंडरस्टैंड, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ डायरेक्टर इन एनी कंपनी, तो आप 10 साल 15 साल तक डायरेक्टर बन सकते हो, देर इज़ नो प्रॉब्लम. बट इफ़ द कंपनी इज़ फॉलोइंग अ स्टैगर्ड बीओडी, स्टैगर्ड बीओडी का मतलब होता है सम डायरेक्टर्स विल हैव टू बी अपॉइंटेड एवरी ईयर. सो इफ़ द कंपनी इज़ अपॉइंटेड मी फॉर लेट्स से 10 years, बट आफ्टर द सेकेंड ईयर आई हैव बीन डूइंग सम फ्रॉड और यू नो सम मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन, देन the board will not elect me in the third year if there is a staggered BOD option. So staggered BOD is quite famous. Staggered BOD India mein bhi use hota hai. So some directors will have to be reappointed in every AGM, that is every year. Next is board's duties and responsibilities. The number one responsibility of the BOD is to safeguard the interest of shareholders. Of course, we know this. BOD जो होता है, those persons actually have to protect the interest of the shareholders. Shareholders only elect the BOD, and BOD will represent their interest. The responsibility is to maintain oversight over management's day-to-day operations. मीनिंग मैनेजमेंट जो होता है, सीनियर मैनेजमेंट विच विल इंक्लूड ऑल द मैनेजर्स एंड ऑल, दीज मैनेजमेंट गाइज विल एक्चुअली फॉलो द डे टू डे ऑपरेशंस एंड ऑल. बट डे टू डे ऑपरेशंस के ऊपर जो ओवरसाइट रखना होता है, दोज चेक्स वुड बी केप्ट बाई द बीओडी. ड्यूटीज ऑफ बीओडी आर, I've created a shortcut SEARS, SEARS, check. S से आता है strategic planning. They have to make all the strategies and implement those. Then there is E, evaluating the company performance, financial reporting, internal controls, etc. Company performance and financial reporting में usually they will check all the numbers. कैसे company ने grow किया है, what is the profit, how is the profit growing, etc., etc. Approving financial and capital structure changes, investments, disinvestments, mergers and acquisitions, etc. See, approving financial and capital structure changes means that if you want to raise debt, to BOD approve karega. If you want to repay debt, BOD approve karega. Any type of capital change would actually be approved by the BOD. Also, investments and disinvestments. These can be in your fixed assets, or if you have excess money and if you want to invest it somewhere, let's say you want to make deposits or you want to invest in shares or bonds, etc. It has to be approved by the BOD. Next is R, risk management. They have to follow each and every function of risk management. If you remember, portfolio management mein ye padha hai. If not, I'll revise it again for you. Risk management mein actually kya aata hai? So first you have to identify the risk. Then you have to measure the risk. Then you have to select either to mitigate this risk, either to shift this risk, or to actually bear the risk. All of this will be actually done by the board of directors. Last, S se aata hai, selecting or replacing the senior management, deciding their remuneration and also evaluating their performance. Because they are actually keeping an eye on the senior management. So, unko select bhi BOD karega, unko nikalega bhi BOD, unka remuneration bhi yahi set karenge, and also their performance would be checked by the BOD. Next part is types of board committees. Now understand, this board of directors जो होता है उसमें let's say there are 15 directors. Now 15 directors cannot meet in every meeting. 15 directors don't understand each and every topic. Let's say out of 15 directors, there are 2 directors who are into say hardcore finance. But there are 2 directors who don't know anything about finance. They are from marketing. अब फाइनेंस वाले डायरेक्टर मार्केटिंग के मीटिंग में बैठ के क्या करेंगे, एंड मार्केटिंग वाले डायरेक्टर फाइनेंस के मीटिंग में बैठ के क्या करेंगे, दैट विल बी अ क्वेश्चन. दैट इज़ वाई द बोर्ड विल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू कमिटीज. नाउ इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू यू कैन सी देर आर 5 टाइप्स ऑफ कमिटीज. द फर्स्ट वन इज ऑडिट कमिटी, देन देर इज नॉमिनेशन एंड रेम्युनरेशन और कॉम्पेंसेशन कमिटी, देन देर इज इन्वेस्टमेंट कमिटी, गवर्नेंस कमिटी एंड रिस्क कमिटी. यू जस्ट हैव टू नो कि कौन सा कमिटी क्या फंक्शन परफॉर्म करता है. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द ऑडिट कमिटी. सो ऑडिट कमिटी विल ओवरलुक इंटरनल ऑडिट एंड फाइनेंशियल रिपोर्टिंग एफिशिएंसी, इंटरनल कंट्रोल्स, एंड इट रेकमेंड्स एक्सटर्नल ऑडिटर्स, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. सो बेसिकली इंटरनल ऑडिट जो होता है, दैट विल बी डन फ्रॉम एनी पर्सन विच इज नॉर्मली एन एम्प्लॉय और समवन ऑफ दिस कमिटी इटसेल्फ. सो दे विल ओवरलुक द इंटरनल ऑडिट फंक्शन. इंटरनल ऑडिट इज बेसिकली एनी पर्सन हु कैन बी रिलेटेड टू द कंपनी कैन ऑडिट इट. एंड एक्सटर्नल ऑडिट जो होता है, विच इज़ द एक्चुअल फाइनेंशियल रिपोर्टिंग वाला ऑडिट, दैट वुड बी बाय एन इंडिपेंडेंट थर्ड पार्टी. सो इंटरनल ऑडिट जो होता है, यूजुअली ऑडिट कमिटी विल ओवरलुक, एंड दे विल ऑल्सो चेक द इंटरनल कंट्रोल्स एक्सेट्रा, दैट एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग वेल और नॉट. ऑल्सो दे कैन रेकमेंड एक्सटर्नल ऑडिटर्स, दे कैन ऑल्सो रेकमेंड कि ये ऑडिटर्स को निकालना है या नहीं, हाउ आर दीज ऑडिटर्स डूइंग, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. Next is nomination and remuneration or compensation committee. As the name suggests, nomination matlab ke to nominate someone or remunerate someone. So they will select and set remuneration of board members and managers both. So selecting BOD members, selecting managers or setting their remunerations, everything will be overlooked by this committee. Then there's investment committee. So it reviews or approves management's investment decisions. Investment decisions like acquisition or sale of assets or of companies, or we can say mergers and acquisition, etc. So any kind of investment or disinvestment needs to be approved by this committee. Then there is governance committee. It will ensure compliance to laws. It will set out a code of conduct, fraud reporting policies, etc. Governance ka matlab, if you remember, how the actual company will function. So for the company to function well, you need to have some written code of conduct. तो ये रिटन कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट जो है या फ्रॉड रिपोर्टिंग पॉलिसी या विसल ब्लोइंग पॉलिसीज ये सब कौन सेट करेगा? गवर्नेंस कमिटी. ऑफकोर्स कंप्लायंस टू लॉज इज द नंबर वन फैक्टर. कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस के लिए नंबर वन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज कंप्लायंस टू लॉज. एंड द लास्ट वन इज रिस्क कमिटी. सो इट विल आइडेंटिफाई, मेजर एंड मिटिगेट रिस्क. दिस इज नोन एज रिस्क मैनेजमेंट, एस्पेशली फॉर BFSI कंपनीज. रिस्क कमिटी जो होता है वो BFSI कंपनीज में ज़्यादा होता है. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय BFSI? बैंकिंग, फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज एंड इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, और इन अदर वर्ड्स आई कैन से ऑल द फाइनेंशियल कंपनीज. सो दीज आर द 5 टाइप्स ऑफ बोर्ड कमिटीज. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दीज कमिटीज देर आर वेरियस अदर कमिटीज. लाइक इन इंडिया देर इज समथिंग नोन एज स्टेक होल्डर रिलेशनशिप कमिटी. स्टेक होल्डर रिलेशनशिप कमिटी क्या करता है? तो हर एक स्टेक होल्डर का कंप्लेंट्स या ग्रीवेंसेज होता है, इट विल एक्चुअली ट्राई टू रिजॉल्व दोज. सो देर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ कमिटीज, बट इन आवर करिकुलम 5 कमिटीज हैव बीन कंसिडर्ड. Next point says, each committee comprises of various board members who have specific roles. Each committee will report to the BOD. मतलब ये committee में कौन बैठेंगे? Who will be the members of this committee? Those members who are actually from the board of directors. Also, BOD is the final authority. Now, beneath BOD are committees. ये committee 1, committee 2, committee 3, etc. Meaning all the committees will report directly to the board of directors. The composition of the board committee is often based on its function. Which committee will have which type of directors, that will depend on the function. So normally audit committee, compensation or remuneration committee and governance committees shall comprise of non-executive, meaning external directors or independent directors only. Why? Because audit, compensation and governance, these are quite sensitive issues. अब audit में fraud हो सकता है, governance में laws को comply नहीं किया तो problem हो जाएगा. So these committees better have independent directors, meaning non-executive, which are not actually my employees. If my employees are on the board, they will be biased, they will be impartial and they will have a soft corner for the company, which is not actually needed. So independent directors ye committees mein zyada honge. Local laws shall prescribe rules regarding the composition, meetings, etc. of the committee meetings. Basically there are rules, like even in India, kitna meetings hona chahiye, meetings start kaise hona chahiye, how do you send the notice of the meeting, notice mein kya likhte hai, etc. etc. So local laws will prescribe these rules, which of course we are not required to know. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKeda.